Hello you beautiful audience. This is Reddit Stories. And today's topic is Doctors/Medical Examiners/Morticians of Reddit, what is the weirdest anomaly you've ever found on/in a body? A mummified foetus. I was working in Africa and the usually very stoic Congolese surgeons called me into theater, gagging. The patient was an elderly woman with a protruding abdominal mass. When they opened it, they found that it was a long dead mummified foetus which as a result of an ectopic pregnancy, had somehow managed to both wall off after it died and somehow avoid killing the mother. Her body had encapsulated the alien tissue and over the years, it had slowly eroded her anterior abdominal wall to the point where it finally caused her to have enough symptoms to get something done about it. It was horrific and the smell was worse. Happily, though, the patient survived the procedure and just left the surgical team with a memory. When my mom was a mortician, I would hang out in the mortuary watching TV. Her boss showed me a guy who had retained water and drowned. His balls were the size of a grapefruit. Not the most pleasant thing to see at age 15. When you poked him, he moved like a waterbed. In med school I had to do a pelvic on a woman during my M rotation and found a meth pipe. She forgot she put it there during a traffic stop. I also had to remove a nail from a guy's head. He figured it must have went off while reloading. He had intractable tooth pain, so he got sent by his dentist for a CT and lo and behold there was a nail in his cranium. Guy came in for an outpatient MRI of his cervical spine. On the form where it asks if he ever had any metal in his body, specifically asks if any injured by a metal object, he selected no. Same with a verbal questionnaire. Also we do a keyword search in the patient's heart chart for the term foreign body in case it's documented nothing came up. He lays down, and I start taking images while talking to him though the speaker. During one of the image sets he starts pounding on the inside of the scanner and screaming. Figured he was claustrophobic so I stop the machine and get him out. Immediately he jumps up and starts talking nonsense and runs into the wall, screaming he needs to get away from the ocean. I call overhead for emergency room staff to come down and security as he's flailing, continues screaming and running into the wall before we restrained him. The staff rush down, and he's talking a mile a minute and explaining how he is inside of the poster of the beach that covers the entire wall in the room he's in, scared out of his mind and hallucinating. Security restrains him, and he's taken down to get an x-ray of his skull. There was a BB in his frontal lobe. It had just enough ferrous metal left in it to travel a few millimeters in his brain. In the emergency department he kept trying to escape, and was very fast. While unrestrained he got up, somehow convinced the guard he was better. Patient bolted out of his room into the main hallway. A code was called for a lost patient. For over an hour nobody could find him, until a nurse looked into a large storage closet. Poor guy was found in a pool of blood. He crashed into a large mirror that was leaning on the wall. And had severe lacerations of his neck, face, and arms. Efforts were made to transfuse him but it was too late. Still haunts me how a simple BB from 40 years earlier could do that. Discovered his brother accidentally shot him with a BB gun when they were kids. The weirdest thing I've ever faced as a doctor is also by far the saddest, and I still think about it every now and then. 5-year-old kid with oropharyngeal cancer caused by human papillomavirus warts. She had been sexually abused since she was 2 years old or even younger by her father, which was now in jail, and got the cancer because of continuous oral sex abuse that caused papilloma to grow on her throat. No mother in sight, was being raised by foster family. When she arrived to us, the growth was already blocking her trachea and eventually she underwent surgery to remove the tumor. Then chemo. Then other 5 different surgeries. When I stopped working there she was breathing through a tracheostomy hole and still under treatment. Bad prognosis. It's been 5 years since I left and she is probably dead by now. and it haunts me because no one told me in college that my profession would make me see the worst part of mankind. Neurologist here, we don't get as many cool stories as the ER docs. However, when I was a medical student, we had a cadaver with a very large and very tiger-striped tattooed penis. This was the only tattoo this man had, and was very unexpected when it came time to genital dissection. Obviously, this was saved by the staff for use on all of our anatomy exams. You walk around the room to different parts/bodies and identify whatever is tagged, and this specimen was always identifiable by the only laughing medical student as they kept rotating around the room. Father owns a crematory. We once cremated a man, with no clothes and not in any container, and along with his ashes came a massive belt buckle. I kid you not, we have no idea how it got in him, but it was definitely there. Teratoma consisting of a couple molars as an incidental finding in a pelvis x-ray, it was in the patient's uterus. Guy in his 20s who had a neck x-ray. It was discovered that the peg holding his head onto his body was congenitally absent, sans odontoid. It's probably a good thing he never played football. I had a patient intern year who had an interesting story about his abdominal pain and constipation. CT showed a can of hairspray which had been inserted rectally but migrated up his sigmoid to the descending colon. It had to be removed surgically, rectoscopes could not grasp the end of the can. I have an x-ray saved somewhere, I'll see if I can find it. My colleague was embalming an autopsied male and found two hair nets, numerous plastic tissue sample slides, a plastic urine container, with another person's name on it, and over 27 latex gloves within his abdominal cavity. ER nurse, man comes in after a car accident, we do a brain scan for safety and find a 3-inch nail embedded in his brain. Ask man about it, he says he has no idea. ER admits he was once shot with a nail gun but had no idea a nail had been lodged in his head. Had been there for well over 4 years. Edit, originally said 6-inch, meant 3. Interned within me and we had a case where the death was very, very sudden. He didn't really complain about any pain or anything, and then was gone. We open him up and there's blood behind a kidney. Almost an entire liter of blood in the cavity, with no sign at all of internal bleeding. Not really fitting with the question posed, but a medical oddity just the same. My mother-in-law miscarried twice before she had my husband and his twin brother. She had some kind of cyst or protrusion in her uterus that once one of the previous fetus got to a certain week of growth. It would rub against the protrusion and rupture the sac, and the fetus would not be at a point of viability and would perish. So when she became pregnant with twins, she knew inevitably she would sadly lose them at that stage. The time frame comes and goes. Fetuses are still okay and growing normally. Comes time to have them, early as with twins, and lo and behold, not only are they in the same amniotic sac, but the other twin sac is around the one they shared. They were double bubbled. They had twin transfusion syndrome, so no one at the time had a moment to think about it, life or death emergency at that time, but the fact that they were double wrapped is more than likely the only reason they made it that far. Both survived the twin transfusion, very rare in the early 80s for one if not both to die. Just an amazing story, I think. A real grub inside a tooth. An old patient came to us with a long-term and several pain in her tooth. The doctor extracted the tooth and put it into a tray. After 1 minute, we saw a grub crawling out from the tooth. This woman had lived with it for at least 6 months. I've told this story on Reddit before but, I think on my other account. I worked in medicine as an x-ray tech/medical assistant. One day we had a patient come in complaining of a stomachache. Considering the time of the year, it wasn't an abnormal complaint to have come in our family practice. So we run him through the normal test urinalysis, and an abdominal x-ray, KUB for those medically inclined. Well, he was a shorter fella so I had a lot of room on the film. This kind of x-ray is one large shot centered on your belly button. It's mostly used to see how full of shit you are. I went to the dark room to process his film when something weird could be seen near his butt. There was definitely a lot of poop backed up, but I couldn't tell what was causing the blockage. I showed the doc the film and she busted out laughing. The doctor I worked with was usually stone-faced and serious about these kinds of things. So it was odd, we were all confused. She asked me to go into the room with her while she asked him some questions. The first thing she asked him was what he shoved up his butt. I was so taken aback by the statement I almost missed what he said. You see, this 40-year-old man has diarrhea the week before and decided to shove a tampon up his butt to stop it. He tried to take it out but the string got caught, and then he simply forgot about it. We had to remove it. It was disgusting, and I never did another procedure ever again. In my anatomy lab, my group's cadaver had died from systemic complications of stage 4 lung cancer, and when we got to the lungs they were two rock hard, necrotic blackened masses that looked nothing like the other cadaver's pink and spongy lungs. My anatomy prof took one lung out and wrung it, resulting in this putrid black goo flowing out of the lung. As he was draining the lung, he mentioned in an Indian accent, This is what happens when you smoke. Heard a story from a urologist when I was in medical school about a guy who came in for a vasectomy. During the procedure, the urologist has trouble finding the vas deferens. So he orders a few tests. Turns out the guy has bilateral congenital absence of the vas deferens, CAVD. But the guy had 3 kids. She isn't dead, but this week I saw a patient with endometriosis in her lungs. Somehow, womb lining cells had traveled to her thorax and colonized on the lung. She previously had symptoms of coughing up blood while menstruating, but because the endometriosis was so severe, was on the pill to stop her periods entirely. Then she came off it to have a baby, and after the birth, with her hormones all over the place, she developed 2 pulmonary embolisms, blood clots in the lung, and a few weeks after that, 3 successive pneumothorax, collapsed lung. The womb cells had tried to shed, and made a hole between the airways and the sac surrounding the lung, letting air escape. She's deciding now whether to let the surgeons cut out the part of her lung with the endometrial cells, to go back on the pill for life, or to have a full hysterectomy and remove her ovaries. Tough choice at 32. I was a combat medic in the army. Not super uncommon, about 1 in 10,000 people have it, but I had a buddy with situs inversus. All of his major internal organs were reversed, heart on the right side instead of the left, for example. As soon as he got to the unit, it was the first thing he told me. Wanted to make sure if he got hurt I wasn't curious as to why he had no heart, I guess. Here's another weird one. 3 golf balls in a man's stomach. His cause of death was lung cancer. Still trying to figure out how he ate golf balls / how long they were in there considering he was on life support for 2 weeks before he died. During an autopsy, we found a plastic shamrock that was about 3 to 4 big in some guy's stomach. Another guy had the biggest piece of steak in his throat. Cause of death was obviously choking. Pretty memorable to me. I'm a doctor was working in OT, anesthesiology. An emergency came in the afternoon. Apparently the patient is a fisherman and got into a fight with his fisherman friend. Patient was impaled by a spear gun. The spear entered just lateral to his belly button and came out just above his right hip. He actually held this 6 feet long spear going through his body and walked into the emergency room by himself. When it was time to put him under, he wasn't scared / anxious. He said, just fix me up so I can go find that guy. I was a nurse for the ER and a dude came in with a big vibrating dildo stuck in his ass and it was still on and we had to wait for the batteries to die before we could even do anything. There were 2 big DD-sized batteries. He was there for like 3 hours laying on a table ass vibrating. Not a pathologist, but I work in a coroner's office. On more than one occasion we have directed a post-mortem on someone who has died abroad, often due to heart-related issues. I once got a phone call from the pathologist after he had opened the body to examine the heart. This person died from a heart attack, yes. Apparently so. You want me to examine the heart? Yes, please. Where is it? Some other countries routinely remove organs when they are determining a cause of death, then the body is embalmed and sent back to their home country. We still often have to confirm the cause of death, so I've spent a lot of my time chasing missing organs around the world. Worked in a funeral home, had a friend at the medical examiner's office. A father was thought to have died of a heart attack and he came to our funeral home. Next morning. The pathologist comes in and looks at the notes. Calls us in a panic. We rush the body to the medical examiner's office. A few weeks later, I ask my friend what happened. The guy was actually murdered and was shot. Had a kid, anus imperforate, not that uncommon. Basically, his intestines ended in a blind pouch. What was odd though, is that his genitals were rotated. When you took off his diaper, the scrotum sat on top, the penis was under it. Pointing back. A fair number of cloverleaf head kids. An omphaloceal that contained all of the large intestine, the liver, part of the small, and part of a lung. Young man comes in complaining of headache. I work in radiology. We ask for history. Nothing to report, he says. We scan his head. CT shows a bullet rattling loose inside his sphenoid sinus, kind of between the nasal cavity and the brain. I ask the guy, have you ever been shot in the face? Oh, yeah, I guess I forgot to mention that. This reminds me of a course I had in college taught by the chief medical examiner of Los Angeles. He went through some of his landmark cases and the craziest one was the story of an Iranian man and his wife. The man had a student visa but the wife was denied one so he tried to smuggle her out of the country in his luggage. When they arrived in LA and he opened his bag to find her suffocated, he left it there. He committed suicide next day. Super crazy story. I think there's a doc about it. I'm a paramedic. I had a 911 call for a woman with a quartz stone in her lady bits. During the ride to the hospital I asked why she put it up there. She said she hits it with her vibrator to add pleasure and every now and then I can't get it out. I'm a carer for the elderly at a hospital. A nurse asked me to help her insert a catheter into a lady with dementia, but when we propped her legs open there was a horrific smell and we could see something dark in the vaginal cavity. It was a teddy bear. We think it was there a while. I work as a statistician in a major hospital so I see and catalog a lot of weird things. Worst thing I'd seen was someone come in complaining of leg pain and showing signs of septic shock. After examination DR orders scans and there's two metal rods, one in each leg, that weren't on their file. Turns out the patient has been to SE Asia to get a height-altering surgery and the DR had used items you'd pick up from the local hardware store to fix the bones after breaking. After extensive surgery patient lost the lower part of one leg and was lucky to keep the second. I was a mortician for a religious organization, and I have to say that the butt plug conundrum of 2013 was among the more difficult issues I faced in the field. A decedent arrived in my morgue with a bejeweled butt plug firmly in place within the rectum. Which led to a very interesting issue if the family had known that the deceased was likely to have had such an item. We'd be screwed if we didn't list it amongst personal effects to be returned to the family. But if they were as vanilla as most of the relevant religious community claimed to be, such an item would probably be considered a slanderous perversion. Fortunately, my boss was a member of the relevant clergy, so I simply removed the item and popped it into a biohazard bag for him to decide upon. Not me, but my boyfriend's mom is a doctor for people with special needs. One of her patients, an older man with Down syndrome, among other diagnoses, appeared to have extreme abdominal pains that lasted for weeks. They did several tests and tried some medication, but the pain wouldn't stop. He also suffered from constipation and stopped eating altogether at some point. The source of his trouble remained a mystery for almost 2 weeks, and the doctors were starting to get desperate. Then suddenly one afternoon, my boyfriend's mom got a call from her clinic. She's the head of the department, so they let her know when something important happens while she's not on duty, that this man had finally been able to go to the toilet, and among some stool was a blue latex glove. Over the following days he passed about 20 of these in total, and he felt better and better and luckily started eating again. Most likely he had somehow been able to steal the gloves from the cleaning lady's cart and ate them without anybody knowing / seeing, causing the gloves to get stuck in his intestine while absorbing his digested food, filling up like little poop balloons in his stomach. This really is one of the weirdest stories I've ever heard, but my boyfriend's mom said he had been known for eating weird stuff, like this one time he ate a t-shirt. TLDR: man experiences abdominal pains, unable to shit and stops eating. After nearly 2 weeks of this, he starts shitting blue latex gloves filled with poop and feels fine again. This marks the end of the video. If you like my content, consider subscribing as it helps me a lot. See you until next time.